Another aspect of genomics is personal genomics, and this is looking at your own individual genome, not humans in general. And personal genomics can be used to answer a variety of questions. One of the big ones is, what is your risk of a particular disease? And personal genomics can sort of answer some of those questions. It can, for certain diseases, give you a yes or no answer. Other times, it can give you some kind of percent risk. So for diseases that we know have a specific genetic cause, something like cystic fibrosis, which is due to a mutation in a single gene, you can get genetic testing and find out, yes, you will get the disease, yes, you're carrier of the disease, or no, you aren't. More diseases, however, are a percent risk. So the BRCA1 gene, for example, is an indicator of your probability of getting breast cancer. And so women with the particular version of the BRCA1 gene have a 40 to 60% chance of getting breast cancer. And then you can make decisions about that. If you remember a few years ago, Angelina Jolie had a radical mastectomy. That was a decision based on personal genomics, knowing that she had the genetics for that particular disease. One of the risks of personal genomics is, what are you going to do with the information that you get? For example, you can get tested for your risk of Alzheimer's, but at the time I'm making this video, we don't have any real treatments for Alzheimer's. So you want to think about, if there's not any treatment available, do you want to know if you have the potential to get a disease? For some people, knowing that risk might cause depression or a change in lifestyle. For other people, knowing that risk may help them plan for the future and make arrangements. So knowing your percent risk is something that needs to be carefully considered in terms of, do you want to know these answers or not? There are a variety of other areas in personal genomics, some of which are promised but haven't really come through yet. Pharmacogenomics is the idea that maybe we should look at personal genomes when we decide what medications to give someone. That maybe your specific genome means you won't react well to a medicine where someone else will. Should we develop personalized medicine for people? Again, understanding that not all humans are identical may be the future of medicine and medical treatments. And even away from sickness, could we use our genomics to understand nutrition and exercise? Maybe someone would do better with aerobic activity, someone would do better with eating more protein and less fats, while someone else would be better with more carbohydrates and less proteins. This is the future, potentially, of personal genomics. We're really not quite there yet. There are certainly companies that are trying to sell you the fact that we are there, but we really aren't quite there. Finally, personal genomics can get you your ancestry information. And there's often TV shows about this where you can figure out what percent you are Native American or French, German, Irish. I will tell you, my sister went ahead and did this with one of the companies and found out we're exactly what we think we are. So German, Irish family from Northern Europe. But sometimes you can get some interesting information from those kinds of companies. This video, which you'll watch in a few minutes, includes information about genetic testing and some of the considerations that you should take if you're considering using genetic testing. Another aspect of personal genomics is DNA fingerprinting. And this is when we use DNA to identify criminals, missing persons, figure out who the father is, that kind of thing. This is a little bit different than figuring out the exact genome, and this video is going to walk you through exactly how DNA fingerprinting is done. It is different than actually figuring out the A, T, C's, and G's. Before we get to those next two videos, I just want to briefly mention the epigenome. This is the study of how genes are turned on and off in our genome. One of the key findings in recent epigenetics is, just because a gene is there doesn't mean that it's going to be expressed. And so just having something in your genome is not the same as having the protein actually being built We're going to cover this a little bit more when we get to genetics, but it's a fascinating interaction of the environment and our DNA.